Now, the objective of this tutorial is to download a particular font off the web, then install it into our machine and embed the generation code into our web projects. We have created a separate root folder inside which we have created this separate CSS folder, inside which we have created a stylesheet.css of our own, and we have created an index.html page. This is the index.html page and this is the stylesheet.css that we have produced. In doing so, the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to Google, and here we will be looking for free to commercialize fonts. We will be getting this free fonts, legit free and quality font squirrel. So we will be right clicking onto it and we will be opening this link into a new tab. And there it goes. Now before doing anything, see this disclaimer over here. It says that it is free to commercial work. On the other hand, we need to check on whether all these icons, those are activated or not. You can see that all these four icons are highlighted. That means you can use it for commercial desktop purpose. That means it will be enabling you to create commercial graphics and documents. You can use it into websites with CSS. You can use it into ebooks and PDFs, or you can use it in applications like developing your own software. So you need to check on whether all those things are highlighted or not. And after that, you need to download this TTF file format. Now this is a TTF font, that means true type font. So the font that will be downloaded into your machine will be a TTF font. All you need to do, you need to download it. Once the download is complete, you will see that a zip file will be downloaded like this one. And on extracting it, you will be getting all these file formats here into a .ttf version. If you want to install it into your machine, then no problem. Choose the Rubik regular .ttf. This is the regular font. You need to double click on it, then press install, and this one will be automatically installed into your machine. But in case of web embedment, there's a lot bigger thing that is to be done here. Hopefully, if we get back to Google and if we look for font face generator, you can see that in the first link, this is the Font Squirrel's font face kit. So again, right click onto it and open link in a new tab. There it goes, and this is the web font generator. Now you can see there is an upload fonts button here. So we have to click. All you need to do, you need to select that particular font that you want to generate. So that is why you need to get back to the folder where we have extracted all those things, and from here we will be uploading this .ttf. And here it goes. Here it is now being uploaded. Check that this optimal setting is been checked here, and in this agreement term you need to check this box that the fonts that you are uploading are legally eligible for web embedding. Now all you need to do, you need to download your kit, and once you press this button here, you will be getting something like this one, this webkitgenerator.zip. That means on clicking this button, you will be getting a .zip format version that will be downloaded into your machine, and that will be this one. If we do extract it, we will get this set of files, those have been present over here. And as you can observe, here is another stylesheet.css which is being downloaded off the internet. If you click it on and open it with Atom, you will see that something inside will be like this one. We need this code. And on the other hand, we also need all these file formats. Those will be required to run this font into your web project. So that is why we will be copying these things and we will be pasting it into the CSS folder where we have already created our own stylesheet.css. So paste it over here, and once again, this is the one that is actually generated by Font Squirrel, as you can see here, and this is the stylesheet.css that we have created for our project. So in the very first case, all we need to do, we need to set up for our project. So that is why we are getting back to index.html, and here we are now creating these two tags. It's a very basic tag, an h2 tag. We are naming it into a different one. We are now providing another h1 tag here. So we have created these two tag lines right over here. If we now get back to our project, there it goes. And we can see that all of them are now currently set into the default version of HTML. Everything is default here. Now let's get back to our own CSS. And here, first of all, we are mentioning that the background of this HTML will be, for say, this one. And here, in the first case, we are just changing this color and the text align center. Now if we just get back to our project, we are practically ensuring that our index.html is linked to stylesheet.css. If we now just reload, we can see that it is now presently working. We haven't changed this color here of this h1 tag that we have created. So we will be now producing it in the similar fashion. First of all, we are providing this color. I think we'll be providing it a yellow one. And we will be mentioning this text align as center. Now get back and reload. And yes, it is now working. There's absolutely no problem with it. Now all we need to do, this is the web embedded code that is needed to support the font that we have downloaded off the internet across every machines worldwide. So that is why we will be copying it. We'll be getting back to our very own style sheet, and above all, we will be pasting it here. We need this font family. Copy this one, paste it here, put some font weight. For say it is 500. We are making sure that everything is in order. So we are getting back to CSS. And here we can see that every file formats, this .ttf, .woff, .woff2, everything is in place. So now we are getting back to our project and we are reloading. And we can see that this font is now being matched into our machine. That means if we now copy this whole project here and try to play it into another machine where this particular font is not present, even there this font will be matched and there won't be any problem, absolutely no problem in playing this thing. So that is how we can use web embedded code online, and we can use them into our web project, or we can install it into our machine.